new health legislation, now the law of the land in Georgia. It's going to give people more access to much-needed medical treatment. Atlanta News First political reporter Doug Reardon live outside of the old Atlanta Medical Center that is now shut down. Doug, today's bill signing, it's going to make it much easier for hospitals and healthcare centers to be built in Georgia.
Yeah, that is essentially exactly what it does. It rolls back a lot of the restrictions that made it tough to do so here in our state. And this is going to be beneficial for people living in both rural and city settings. Of course, you mentioned we're right here outside of Atlanta Medical Center, which shuttered last year, leaving a lot of folks in the metro Atlanta area with far less options for health care.
That affects me as a provider because I want as much access as possible for all my patients. I want them to have choices.
And right now, Dr. Cecil Bennett says his patients don't have as much choice as they should when it comes to where they get their health care.
It's just not fair. In a country as rich as our country is, in a state like Georgia, patients should be able to access care much more easily.
Part of that problem was fixed this week. Since the 1970s in Georgia, if you wanted to build a hospital or a health center anywhere in the state, you had to have what's called a certificate of need.
There has to be enough documentation that facility is actually needed in that particular community.
With the stroke of his pen on Friday, Governor Brian Kemp eased regulations so hospitals could be built with less red tape. And it's not just hospitals. The bill also makes it easier to build psychiatric, substance abuse, prenatal, and outpatient centers.
These projects will help meet one of the greatest needs facing our state, and that is our healthcare industry, having a well-trained, capable healthcare workforce.
Certificate of need was originally meant to make sure unnecessary construction didn't happen, passing the cost onto local residents. But with shrinking health care options in metro Atlanta, this is a welcome change to many providers like Dr. Bennett, who are constantly referring patients to bigger or more specialized facilities.
I want there to be choice, that basically the more competition, I believe the better care my patients will get.
And the governor also signed another bill in Athens today, right after this one, that would give tax breaks to doctors and nurses who go to work at rural healthcare facilities here in Georgia. Outside of Atlanta Medical Center, Doug Reardon, Atlanta News First.